Hello, and welcome to another EGMS tutorial. My name is David Dabb, and today we're going to cover the subrecipient organization registration process. So if you remember from our last tutorial video, last time we covered the subrecipient login page and how it works, how it looks, and all the things that are contained within, and the three primary purposes, which is to be able to log in, to be able to register, and to be able to view published funding opportunities that LASA has published. Today, like I said, we're going to be talking about the registration process. So if your organization has not registered yet in the EGMS, that's what we're going to be covering today. If your organization has already registered in the EGMS, you're not going to be able to register again. You may only register one time. Now, to begin the registration process in the EGMS, we're going to go ahead and click on the register button here. From here, we're going to take you to an instruction page. And on this instruction page, we basically let you know what is required for you to register. The main things that are required to register are an EIN number, a DUNS number, and your organization needs to be registered with SAN.gov. If you need an EIN and you don't have one yet, we provide a link here in order for you to go and get one. Same thing with the DUNS number. If you need a DUNS number and you don't have one, we provide a link here for you to get one. And then finally, for SAM.gov, we also provide a link to SAM.gov here. So that way you can be registered in SAM.gov if you're not already. Once you do have all three of these things, your EIN, your DUNS, and your registered in SAM.gov, you may go ahead and continue to begin your registration. At this point, you're taken to a Terms and Conditions for Authorized Users page. These are some terms and conditions that have been laid out by LASA that you must accept in order to proceed. If you decide to reject these, you'll be taken back to the subrecipient login page and your registration will be canceled. You may always begin your registration again if you would like to, but you'll have to start over. We're going to go ahead and accept. At this point in time, you're now going to be prompted to enter your EIN and your DUNS number and select your organization category. Is your organization a government agency, a nonprofit entity, or a for-profit entity? So here you're going to enter your EIN and your DUNS number. So let me go ahead and do that. I'm going to go ahead and select nonprofit. And then what you're going to do is you're going to click on search. And that's going to check your information in SAM.gov. If your organization exists in SAM.gov and your DUNS and EIN are verified, you can now go ahead and click on save and continue to begin. At this point, you must accept a certifying statement that LASA has prepared. So as you're registering, please read through the certifying statement and accept if you would like to proceed. If you reject, once again, your registration will be canceled and you'll be taken back to the subrecipient login page. We're going to go ahead and accept. Once you've accepted, you can see that all of the organization's information is automatically populated from SAM.gov. And you can see the instruction text here. Please review the details below. If needed, click cancel and make any necessary updates in SAM.gov. Click confirm when all information is correct. So this information is automatically populated from SAM.gov, like is stated up here. If some of this information is incorrect, we do not allow you to change it here during the registration process in the EGMS. We always want to pull the latest information from SAM.gov. So if information is incorrect, you'll need to go back to SAM.gov and correct it there, and then begin the registration process here in the EGMS again, so that the EGMS can pull the latest information from SAM.gov. If everything is okay, then go ahead and click confirm to confirm that the information here is correct. At this point in time, you're now going to put in your authorized organization representative information. The authorized organization representative is the primary user of your subrecipient organization, and they will be responsible for managing your organization profile. They will be responsible for submitting applications, and they will be responsible for finalizing contracts and things like that. This is a very important user. The authorized organization representative may also invite secondary users from their organization to register in the EGMS, and secondary users may assist them, but the authorized organization representative is the primary user who is responsible for managing the organization in the EGMS. So the information you provide here is very important. Make sure that the person's information that you enter here is the person you want to be using the EGMS on behalf of the organization the most. I would not recommend you put somebody like a CEO in here, even though a CEO might be the main person in charge of the organization. You don't necessarily want the CEO to be the one who is managing the organization in the EGMS. So put somebody in here who has that main responsibility. I'm going to go ahead and just enter some test information here. Once you're happy with the organization representative's information, you can go ahead and click on Confirm. At this point in time, you'll be presented with a reCAPTCHA page. The purpose of this page is simply to ensure that bots aren't creating registrations for organizations. Registrations should be done by humans, so we just want to confirm that you're a human. So go ahead and click the checkbox. You may or may not have to take a test of some sort, right? If you're familiar with how the internet operates and you've dealt with reCAPTCHA systems before, you may be presented with like an image test to ask you to select all the pictures with crosswalks in them or select all the pictures with cars in them, something like that. Some kind of minor test. You might not have to do it like you saw here. It depends on the reCAPTCHA system. Once you have confirmed that you're not a robot, go ahead and click on Submit. And at that point in time, after you've submitted, your registration has now been successfully submitted to the EGMS. And you get a confirmation message here letting you know that your registration submission has been successful. Now that your registration has been submitted, the EGMS is going to automatically set up a user account for you using that authorized organization representative's information. And the EGMS is going to add your organization into the EGMS from SAM.gov. From here, you're going to receive two emails. The first email is going to be very similar to this success message. It's just a success email letting you know that your registration has been submitted successfully. The other email you're going to get is from Salesforce.com, and that email will provide you instructions with how to set up your username and password. So I'm going to go ahead and access the email. And here, I have received that email from Salesforce.com. And this contains the instructions that you need. Basically, what you need to do is you just click here, and that will take you to the EGMS, and here you'll set up your password. So let me go ahead and set a password here. And once your password has been set, you'll be logged into the system. And now you can see we're successfully logged into the system as demonstration user that we registered with. In upcoming tutorial videos, we'll show you how to start working on your organization profile. After you've registered, your very first pending task that you will need to work on is to work on your organization profile and submit that organization profile to LASA so that way they know that you are ready to apply for funding opportunities. So that will be your first task, and we'll cover that in a later tutorial video. We may also have tutorial videos for things like how to apply for funding opportunities, how to manage your contracts, and things like that. So look forward to those tutorial videos in the future. For the time being though, this is it for today's video. So just as a quick recap, today what we covered is we covered the registration process. We accessed the subrecipient login page. We started our registration process. We successfully entered our EIN and DUNS number. the system, the EGMS system, automatically pulled our organization's information from SAM.gov. We confirmed that our information from SAM.gov is correct. We entered our authorized organization representative's information, and we submitted our registration. From there, the EGMS automatically created a new user account for us and automatically created our organization profile for us and sent us an email with instructions to set our password. We went ahead and we set our password, and now we're able to log into the system. So that's it. That's it for today's video. If you have any questions or concerns, please feel free to reach out to us. We're always happy to help. Thank you so much for watching, and have an incredible day.